Well, hello, all of you beautiful people out there in Minecraft land. How are you today? I am fantastic. Thank you so much for asking. Welcome back to another very exciting episode on the Igniter SMP server. And welcome back to the old intro. Remember that? Yeah, I thought it was time to bring it back. I've been missing it, and I think it's time to return to the old ways. Everything old is new again. You know what I mean? I love it. I do have a very exciting episode to present for you guys today, starting with a farm build. I've been talking for the last couple of weeks with Anita about the possibility of building a brand new farm. And you might have caught wind of it, but if not, let's go meet up with Anita right now and we will talk all about it. Hi. How are you?
I'm fine. How are you?
I'm great. Do you want to go build a blaze farm?
Yeah. Yeah. We've been planning this so long. We need to do it now.
Yes. So we got to fly a long way. Basically that way. We got to go to 2,000 blocks that way across the roof of the Nether. And when you get there, there's just like, there's hardly anything. There's just a tiny little like piece of glowstone and hopefully you'll spot it. Right here, this little piece of glowstone floating in the sky marks a ladder down into the scary part of the Nether.
You actually made a whole stairway down.
I did, yeah. You asked a minute ago why this was so far away. I was actually looking for something very, very specific when picking a place to build this blaze farm. And what I found was right down here. I actually found two blaze spawners that are very, very close together. So there's one over here, and then there's one over here. And they're on the same Y level, and they're both within just a few blocks of each other. So hopefully when you stand somewhere around here, you should actually activate both of these farms. And I've already kind of built what I wanted to build in creative mode and made a schematic out of it. So it's
easy peasy for us.
Should be a pretty easy build, yeah. And then I also went ahead and cleared out like everything here. This was, you know, me bored one day, and I just decided, you know what, I'm just going to start digging, and I did all this off camera.
Before we're going to continue, I need to turn my light down because I'm blinded by the glowstone.
There's a lot of glowstone here. I kind of went a little overboard with the glowstone. I wanted to make sure that nothing spawned while I was working in here, and yeah. So I managed to disable the spawners pretty easily, but then other things started spawning and yeah, became a hassle. Right up here, I have a little kind of like waiting room or a staging area, whatever you call this. And here it is, all the materials we need. It's actually a pretty low material count. It's just a bunch of lava and a bunch of glass with like two or three little extra things. So it's a pretty easy build. Shouldn't take us more than like 10 minutes or so, but we'll see. So without further ado, let's hit that time lapse.
The farm is done, Fit.
Woo! The farm is done! We did it, and we survived. And we survived. Yeah, there's stuff all over the place here. Yeah, now you get to see how productive this farm actually is, if we can get down. Hopefully there's no glowstone left inside the farm.
No, I don't see any.
I'm gonna put this right here on the wall. This is the Blaze Killer Sword. Beautiful. We should probably put a door on this or something so that piglins don't come up and kill us. But this is it. This is a very nice little farm. Kills them very, very fast. You get tons of XP and blaze rods. Look at that. Blaze rods are already coming in like crazy. You have looting 3 on your sword.
Yep.
Sweeping edge. Oh, don't crouch. If you crouch, they'll see you.
But then they can see us. No, I have sharpness 4 and looting 3, yeah.
Perfect. You know what I need blazer eyes for, right?
Yeah, potion shop.
Potion shop, yeah, exactly.
Your,
The biggest thing that I've been having trouble with is keeping blaze rods so that I can have enough to make all the different potions I want to make. So
yeah, your red ravagers, right?
Yep, exactly. Ow. By the way, did you drink your red ravager energy drink?
I had
two of them while I was working, and they were very nice, very good.
I have used the two you gave me. So
swords on the wall. I'm gonna leave it here. So when we come back, we can always use this sword if you don't bring your own for some reason. I don't bring my own sword when I come to a farm because I don't carry a sword. That's just one of those weird things about me. Well, there it is. There's the farm. It's not the prettiest thing in the world. I mean, it's just a whole bunch of yellow glass. And I didn't leave exactly this place very pretty with all the glowstone scattered and the, you know, various netherrack and nether brick from the fortress that I basically was working in the middle of here. But maybe we can come back here some point and do a little bit of decoration, make it look a little prettier. All right, well, thanks so much for your help.
Yeah, you're welcome. And also, thank you for helping me. So this is a two-way.
No problem, no problem. This is going to be very beneficial for both of us.
Yes.
So the new Blaze Farm is very, very productive. I got about a full stack. No, not full stack, a full inventory full of blaze rods in probably about, you know, 30 to 40 minutes of AFK at the farm. Just, swinging away. That was pretty good. But right now, I thought I saw somebody down near the front door of the casino, so I'm going to fly down there and check out who that is.
Oh, there he is.
Well, hello!
Hi! Excuse me. Vid, is it?
That's me, Vid MC.
Okay. Okay, awesome. Well, this place is awesome. And I was playing this random game over there, and I got this box, which seems...
Is that from the arcade over there? Wait, this is a cyan box.
No, it's from you. Oh! Yeah, so it's supposed to be pretty valuable, but
I got the exotic unique box.
Yeah, like, it seems like it'd be good. I was kind of just... I mean, I'm not trying to be picky here.
Yeah.
I don't have armor. I don't have anything. I'm brand new.
Okay, just stay calm. She doesn't know. Just try to look natural. Just pretend everything is totally fine. Just don't go crazy.
Yeah. So, is there any way you could, like, put me in contact with them or something like that? I don't even know how to redeem this.
You're new to the server, right?
Right.
You know what you could use? You could use some diamonds, I'm sure, right?
Oh, 100%. It would be amazing to be able to have some gear, armor,
stuff. I have an offer for you.
Okay. I'm listening.
What if I, take this IOU off your hands and give you a few diamonds for it?
That would be amazing.
Yeah.
That's even better than I was hoping. Oh my gosh. That would be awesome.
Yeah, yeah. How about, like, I don't know, 10, 15 diamonds? Is that...
I don't know.
I'll tell you what. You know what? I'm gonna go top tier for you, okay? I'll give you 64 diamonds for that IOU.
Oh, wow. So this is okay. Yeah, no. I'll handle that. That's like a whole set.
Yes. Just stay. Yeah, give me 1 second here.
Oh, wow.
I need to find an ender chest. Okay. Hi. Oh,
awesome. Hi. Oh wow. This is amazing.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. You have no idea how amazing this is. There's 64 diamonds for you. Happy to have this, and I'm sure.
Awesome.
I'm sure I will be able to find a good home for Neat Freeze IOU.
Neat Freeze. There. That sounds a lot better.
Yes. That's how you say it. By the way.
Good.
It's Neat Freeze.
Okay. Neat
Freeze.
Let me go try to find a place to settle down. I guess.
Absolutely.
I've been told that there's been a sign placed for me, an area claimed, so I'm going to go try to find that, and
nice.
Yeah, I'm definitely going to be back.
Yeah, and obviously, welcome to the server. We're glad to have you here.
Thank you.
There he is.
Indie Alien Jones, how you doing, sir?
I'm doing well, Vid. How are you doing?
Oh, I am so fantastic. Actually, I wanted you to come over to the casino because I have an idea for a little project that you might be interested in.
Okay, I'm all ears.
Come right this way. Okay. So the reason, by the way, that I'm interested in not only this project, but having you involved in this project is because you actually, you inspired it, in case you didn't know.
Okay, well now I'm really interested.
Yeah, so I know just before you joined Igniter, you've been working a lot on your Indies Realm server, right?
Yes, that's correct.
And one of the projects that you were working on your Indies Realm server, I thought would be perfect for like a multiplayer type server. So that's kind of what I was thinking about for the interior of this ocean monument, maybe putting in a little bit of mini golf.
Ooh, dude, yes. I'm totally in, dude.
Sweet. So I mean, for anybody who doesn't know, this is kind of the way mini golf works. You know, you got ice blocks, you got hoppers for holes. You toss your stuff and it slides along the ice, and hopefully if you get it right, it should just go in. Oh man. Let me try that again. I measured this like perfectly. I'm like, okay, come on, go.
There you go.
There it is. Yeah, so obviously this wouldn't be at this level. It would be like down a level or whatever. In fact, to be honest with you, the whole thing could be like up and down or whatever. Mini golf is like, it's one of those games that you can kind of do whatever you want with. This whole space is available to use. Like, we've got, like, you know, little crevices and stuff over here. And, you know, on both sides, it's very symmetrical. So if we do a course that's not symmetrical, that would probably be a lot better for the space that's in here. But, I'm totally excited to, like, get started on this. And, you know, any inspiration you've got, if you want to, like, you know, take half the course or even, like, all the course or just, you know, suggest some ideas or whatever you like, I'm totally open.
Dude, hey, thank you so much for inviting me to do this. Because I will say, I was a little sad when I left my old world and I didn't get to finish the putt-putt course. So this will be like, this will make up for it.
You know what I mean?
This will redeem the old unfinished putt-putt course. Yeah, dude. I love it. So the whole course is going to be inside of this monument then.
Exactly, yeah. I mean, there's so much possibility with a big empty room, right? So.
Yeah, for sure. I would say, and I don't know, it's just from my own personal experience, we could do 18 holes if you'd like, but I feel like it's kind of a lot.
That might be a lot,
It depends, too, on, like, the level of detail for each hole, you know what I mean? I was doing, like, themed holes, where one hole would basically be, like, the size of this entire thing.
Oh, wow!
it doesn't have to be that big, but...
I was thinking that each individual hole would be, like, kind of small, with, like, a couple, like, bigger or more challenging holes, but then, you know, maybe we can do something where we get, like, all the Igniter members over here and we do, like, a little mini golf tournament one day.
Oh, I would love that. Oh, that would be so amazing. Yes, that would be incredible. We can make up for the fact that the holes are smaller because we can use all kinds of obstacles and stuff like that. Like,
oh, exactly.
Slime or, like, a sticky piston, you know, that push blocks up out of the ground to block the ball and all kinds of little water traps, magma traps, all kinds of stuff.
Definitely. You know, I love some redstone, so I'm totally down for anything like that, so...
Yeah. Okay, well, cool, dude. I'm totally in. I love it. I was wondering what you were going to do with this place, too. Because, I mean, it looks beautiful. It looks crazy from the outside. But I was like, what's he going to do with the inside of this place? So this is amazing.
Yeah. And I'm really looking forward to it. So.
It'll give people more reason to come over to the casino.
They'll
play around a putt-putt. They'll be like, oh, man, I'm knackered from all this putt-putt. I'm able to chill out in here, play some games at the casino.
Yeah, and you know the best part about playing the putt-putt game? It's going to be free. Absolutely free, no charge, not for profit. This is just a fun thing that people can do. Come over here, play some mini golf, and then, like you said, like maybe then go spend some diamonds.
Yeah. I love it, dude. I love it. Well, yeah, I'm looking forward to it. I'm ready to get started as soon as you are.
Cool. Yeah. So I'm sure like either this week or next week or whatever, we'll definitely start laying the groundwork. But I suspect this is going to be a longer project. So something might take us like several weeks, maybe several months. Who knows?
Oh yeah. Right. Yeah, for sure.
Cool. Well, thanks.
Yeah, dude. Woo-hoo. Whoa. Wait, can I show that?
Yeah.
That build?
Yeah, you can show it. Yeah, there are no spoilers on this server, so whatever you show. Do you know what that is?
No.
So this is actually something we might need to get together and talk about at some point. This is the girls' clubhouse.
Yep. Okay.
Yeah. No boys allowed. See? Look. No boys
There's
allowed.
A moat with a fire bridge.
Yeah. Oh, but I know the secret. Do you know the secret of this fire bridge?
What?
Well, here. Check this out. So here's what I want you to do. Okay, I want you to just have a little stand on top of that fire bridge there, and tell me how it feels.
Stand on it right now?
Yeah, just for like a second or two.
While it's on fire. Okay.
You just stand on it. Yeah, oh, okay, get out, get out, get out, get out.
Okay. Yeah, okay, yeah, that burns.
Yeah. Now put these on. Try it again.
Ooh, these are snug.
Yeah. Now give it a try.
Oh, check me out, dude. What is this magic?
This is magic. To see?
Okay.
You know what, honestly?
Breathe,
it's a little smoky. Yeah. It actually, you know, I happened to catch on Anita's live stream where she, actually it was Dano's live stream. She was showing this to Dano. And it turns out, you put Frostwalker on your boots, boom, you can walk right across campfires. No issue.
What?
Yeah.
That's a thing?
That's a thing. I didn't
Dude,
even
I
know was, that. I knew you
I'm
could use, I know you could use Frostwalker for magma, walking across magma, but I didn't know it worked on campfires too. And then apparently it does.
So we could sneak into the girls' clubhouse.
Exactly. I mean, you could probably just jump across there. But we're not allowed. That's the problem. Boys are not allowed.
Boys are not. Well, I'm an alien, so what does that mean for me?
Oh, yeah, good point.
Yeah, that's kind of a gray area. No pun intended. I mean, like, am I allowed inside?
Kind of a gray area, yeah.
Hey, I will say though, it is beautiful.
Pretty spectacular. She knows what she's doing with some glass and some concrete and stuff. Yeah.
You are not kidding. I love the colors, the purple and cyan. That is as beautiful. I want to go in the clubhouse.
I know. There's secret things happening in there. You know, we got to have our own clubhouse. What? That's what I think.
Dude, yep. I was about to say, you know what this means, right?
Yeah, we're gonna have to get the boys together and come up with something. I don't know if it'll look this fancy, but maybe. We got some good builders on the server. I know I couldn't do this. Mine, if I build it, it'll look like that.
Dude, we should just. Hey, what? This place is amazing. We should just build like a little like 2012 like dirt hut. You know what I mean?
The boys' hole. Out. Yeah, it's just like that's what it's gonna be.
The boys' hobbit hole. Yeah.
When she had originally told me she was going to build something here, she was actually going to build it much closer to the casino, and I asked her to back it up because I wanted to have this nice view of the casino when you're walking up the road here. And she said, oh, okay, no problem. But then she built it, and I don't think she realized that building it overhanging the road also blocks the view of the casino. So I've been kind of bugging her for months that, like, well, when you walk up this path here, you don't have the beautiful view of the casino, which is what I wanted. So we kind of compromised. She said, well, what if I build another thing on the other side? Then you get this kind of nice view as you come out from under them. And I said, 100%, yep, that's what I want.
Yep.
So she did it. So
I see it. Yeah, that is actually really cool. Yeah, as you walk through here, it's just like, like the whole thing comes into view. And you're like, whoa, we're hanging out in the girls. Watch how fast she gets here. Look at her, dude. Look at her.
There's Jeff. It's like, what?
Yeah.
Excuse me.
Oh, hello.
You're not supposed to go in there.
We didn't go in.
There?
We're just looking.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah. This specifically says boys are not allowed. And the joke is too good. It's well, see, Indy, he being an alien, he fits into kind of a gray area.
I know.
I'm in a bit of a gray area, if you're picking up what we're putting down. So where does that leave me?
You're in the third category.
Uh-huh.
Uh-huh. Which, first off, I did ask before I made this. Second off, if you want to paint your nails with us, then...
Oh!
Ooh, okay.
is that what it takes? Just painting your nails?
No. I did ask, but we were just wanted to do something with the women of the ladies of the Igniter family. And you
Fair
can
enough.
Do the same with the guys.
Oh,
and
we will. We're already
by the
planning
way,
a boys' hall. So
yeah.
Okay. Speaking of outings with girls. Outings are also things like going to a casino or an arcade. So maybe make some commercials or tell people like, hey, I heard you're organizing a thing for the girls this month. Don't you want to visit the arcade casino?
We'll have to get some flyers going, yeah.
You can make money
ladies out night of this. At the casino.
Just saying. Yeah.
Oh, so this is a scam.
This? No, this is free.
Oh, this is free, so I can go in right now. For free?
No. Yeah, okay. No, but what I'm saying, the only thing we're doing there is that we're actually coming there, all of us, to pick out a paper who organizes the next thing we're gonna do. And once a month, one of us girls organizes something we're gonna help at Ember Space. And then we're gonna have a tea party there. And then, the next month, it can be that I will say we're gonna raid an ancient city.
Okay. Okay.
Just something fun to do.
Yeah.
So you expect us to believe that you guys aren't in there forming some nefarious plans, trying to take over the server? That's what you expect us to believe right now?
She thinks we're gonna believe it's all, you know, tea parties and yeah.
Yeah, you could come and look.
Fingernail painting.
I put out the fires for you. Come on.
Dude, we're in the girls' clubhouse.
Very dark. Very dark.
We're in the girls' clubhouse. Okay.
Just so you guys can see that it's nothing special.
Nothing special.
No, it just needs to be light up. Yeah, you can go up there. That's the treehouse. Yeah.
Oh. I fell out.
Yeah, I'm not responsible for deaths, by the way.
Well, this is nice.
There you can see.
Nice little table and everything.
There you can see, like, all the members up there.
I see that.
Yeah.
Vid, face to your left just a little bit more. Hey, MV, can you step backwards a couple steps? Yep. Look to your right a little bit more, Vid.
The title, we invaded the girls' clubhouse. That's not true.
I don't know what you're talking about. But seriously though, this is really cool.
What's like going on with this banner though? It looks like there's like a flower that's like shooting laser beams out at the rest of the server. That's what I'm seeing.
It does.
Then you should ask Ember what it is. Okay. It's supposed to be a tree, as well. In the same colors as...
I'm gonna go with what Vid said.
But, the only thing... the only reason why it's this big and it's a tree is because Vid wanted some symmetry as compensation for the phoenix birds.
Yeah, I told him the whole story about the tree and the you know, the lines and the view of the casino, so...
Yeah, so we have nothing against aliens or men or boys or everything in between, but we just wanted to do something only with the girls.
No, I
get it. Yeah, no worries.
Oh, and
yeah,
I have here
we're
the...
We're going to retaliate and there's going to be a price to pay, but I get it.
There's the Deno safe exit, or you can use the front exit.
Oh, there's a front door? Oh, nice!
Vid?
Yeah.
Do me a favor. Can you go to the beanstalk and bring me a pig?
A pig?
Yeah.
From the beanstalk?
Yeah, where we landed for the water bucket, there we need at least one pig.
All right. Any idea where I could get a pig?
Maybe at Deno's?
Yeah, okay. I'll see what she's got. I gotta go grab my bed and I'll meet you guys over there.
Yeah.
Did I hear pig MLG?
Yes.
Well, I brought some friends. Oh, well, I had some friends. I had two more, but they all broke off their leads. So just so we're clear, you're telling me we're going to jump off the top of the beanstalk, we're going to land on these pigs, and we're going to, like, sit on them.
Yeah.
So that we don't die.
Yeah.
Is that going to work?
I believe so.
Have you done this before?
Well, I've seen it in a YouTube clip. Well, let's do it differently. I first want to try it off small building, guys.
So I'm just thinking, in order to make this good, or like, is the superstar MLG, like, you've got to push the pig off the beanstalk and then jump and land on it in the air?
Oh. No. Just landing on it will be hard enough.
It's like a two-person job. Like, one person pushes the pig off, then jumps, has to water bucket so that the pig doesn't die when it hits the ground, and the second person has to land on the pig.
Guys, we have a problem. There's a...
Yeah,
it's a guy.
We know.
I don't have any...
this up real quick.
I don't have any stuff. I can fix this. I can fix this.
I have flint and steel.
Just stand there and let the guy, let the badness happen.
Oh my gosh, you make
there we go. Who's got sand? Right. Okay. Yeah, that's fine.
Is he gonna try it from the top? Okay. It's never... He's not gonna do that. If he does it in once, I will give him an IOU.
Yeah?
What? Really?
Yeah, if you do that now and you make it, you get an IOU from me. But you're not gonna make that.
Yeah, you know what? If you do it in one, I'll give you a golden key.
Alright. Let me get my stretch on real quick. Yeah, okay.
He looks so tiny.
Alright, here we go. Here we go.
Oh, the pig.
Here we go.
He's jumping. Uh-oh.
No!
Oh!
He
died.
He died, yeah.
Oh, I'm all the way back in my house.
Oh, no! You didn't set your spawn?
No. This is difficult.
this is like one of the hardest challenges I've ever seen.
I'm too late. Every time.
Yeah, I keep clicking after the pig. It's, you know, it's really difficult to overjump the pig. Mm. Oh, I did it. I took damage, but I landed on the pig.
Hey, I did it too.
Off the thing? Off the thing?
I did it too. No, off the house.
Off the roof. Oh, off the roof.
It did make a damage sound, but I did make it.
Yeah, that's what I was wondering. Did I take damage or did I not take damage?
I didn't take any damage.
It made a damage sound. I already had some damage, so I don't know if I actually took any.
Ow. Why is it so hard?
Yeah.
I don't know.
Fit did it again.
I did it again. Yeah, if you land it perfectly, like, it's possible. So, okay, I gotta try something. Oh, okay, well.
Oh, well,
yeah.
Woo, I got 10 levels!
Oh, because I had 100 and some levels on me just then.
Oh, no. There went a full casino renaming session.
Yeah. Luckily, I just finished renaming all the boxes.
Okay.
Oh, except for my super poop boxes. If you got any extra super poop boxes, let me know.
Send them your way.
I need those.
Okay.
I will probably die.
No, here she goes. Here she goes. Oh, yeah, you nailed it! She nailed
it!
Did it! Right there.
Wow.
First time! Yeah!
Well done.
Meat freeze. That was amazing.
Yeah! I'm keeping those 10 levels.
You deserve it.
Wow. I gotta try it. I gotta try it.
Now you guys have to do it.
You bought him wings.
I'm jumping. Oh, that was so close! That was so close! I was right beside the pig. Off he goes. And...
Oh, not even close!
Oh, you missed!
Not even close!
Here it's coming. Oh, I was way off. Way off the side.
Knee freeze, how'd you do this first try?
I don't know.
Get on my face with that. Alright, here we go. I missed the jump. Let's go, baby.
Oh, what did you land on? Did you do that from the top? What happened?
Yeah, I jumped off. I did it.
I knew you were up there with me, and then I turned around and I looked back and you're on a pig, so for all I know, you did it.
I did it. You'll see it in the video. I did it.
I heard you say you missed the jump, but I'm like, if you missed the jump, why didn't you die?
I don't know. I got lucky or something.
Okay. Here we go. I'm actually very low health right now. Not that it matters, because I'm going to die anyway. Okay, jump it.
Go in the hole.
Trying to land on the pig.
You can do it.
Boom.
Yeah!
Got it.
Of course you
got it. Nailed it.
Yay!
Did it when I fell in the hole and I can't see! Dang it!
Hi! I did it!
You did it!
So good. And that, my friends, is where I am going to end this episode.
episode. I hope you guys enjoyed all of the fun shenanigans we got up today. If you want to see more great content from the other Igniters, feel free to check out all of their links. They are in the description down below. And if you want to see more great content from me, well, hey, you can start by checking out last week's video. Link is on the screen right now. I put a guardian and a creeper in some boats and also put a ceiling on my casino. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next episode. Goodbye! Ow!